might say Daniel Boone is our father. From Cassius Clay to the coal miner's daughter. Sawmills to the Oldville slugger. Hell ain't one peanut butter. We thank God we were born from a mother, a straight from Kentucky. We got golden rods and Fort Knox and big red almond running. Holy Rollers Pass and Copperheads waiting on the second coming. Kaywood led for play by play. I'm no stranger to the rain. From my first breath down to my last name, came straight from Kentucky.
Hey guys, I'm country artist J.D. Shelburne from Taylorsville, Kentucky, and you're watching the Best of Kentucky Awards presented by Kentucky Living Magazine. I'm excited to be a part of this. Thanks for allowing me to come on and play some music and work with you guys. Thanks for all the support through the years as well. Now for your host, the fabulous, most beautiful, and Kentucky native herself, Miss America 2000, the stunning Heather Renee French Henry. Take it away, girl.
Welcome to Kentucky Living's Best in Kentucky Awards. Thanks to our sponsor, Glasgow Barron County Tourism, and all of you for joining us. For more than 70 years, Kentucky Living Magazine has celebrated the energy of Kentucky. Tourism, recipes, gardening, home improvement, and the people who make Kentucky a great place to live. We encourage you to share updates from today's show on Facebook and Twitter, at Kentucky Living, and the hashtag Best in Kentucky. Throughout today's show, we'll be checking in with Kentucky Living's new Around the Table columnist, Heather Bilyeu. She writes the food blog Fueling a Southern Soul, and you can watch her videos as she makes Kentucky Living recipes on KentuckyLiving.com. So, Heather, what are you cooking up today?
Hi, Heather. I'm going to be showing you all how to make my most favorite go-to appetizer for any dinner party. And if you all read the Around the Table column, you know that I love sharing my favorite recipes for you. And we're going to be making a beautiful charcuterie board today. It is not as hard as you think. I'm going to be sharing my favorite tips and tricks, how I pick out my cheeses, and all the things that you need to know for a beautiful charcuterie board. Okay, one of my favorite tips is just to cut this cheese in individual slices. So it's about a quarter inch slice that you'll do. And it just makes it easy for everyone to pick it up and use with their fingers or forks or whatever, it doesn't matter. So to do a really fun little arrangement, you can just alternate the cheese slices. It's really easy with a harder cheese because it stands up on its own. Or if you have a softer cheese, then you can just arrange it in a little pinwheel slice just like this. With the goat cheese, it doesn't matter. You just use a knife and dig right on in. I'll have more tips throughout today's show. Thanks for reading Kentucky Living.
Kentucky Living's Best in Kentucky Awards celebrate the people, places, events, and experiences of our beautiful Commonwealth. As a proud sponsor and partner of tourism agencies and commissions across the state, Kentucky Living is excited to welcome the Commissioner of the Kentucky Department of Tourism, Mike Mangent, to again kick off this year's awards. Mike?
Thanks, Heather, and thanks Kentucky Living for showcasing all that Kentucky has to offer. We are so excited to again welcome visitors to the Commonwealth's wonderful attractions and destinations. 2020 was a devastating year for the tourism industry, but the good news is we are rebounding and the winners of these categories are great examples. Tourism and hospitality create and support thousands of jobs and help to grow our economy across the Commonwealth. It's a perfect time for Kentuckians to rediscover some world-class destinations on a road trip here within Kentucky. And here are three great ideas, according to Kentucky Living readers in the category of day trip. In third place, Red River Gorge Geological Area, Stanton. In second place, Heaven Hill Bourbon Experience, Bardstown. And the winner, Mammoth Cave National Park, Mammoth Cave. What great timing. 2021 is the International Year of Caves, and among the many cave destinations in Kentucky is the longest known cave system on Earth. But Mammoth Cave National Park is also amazing above ground, with 53,000 acres of beautiful forest, 70 miles of nature trail, 13 backcountry campsites, 3 campgrounds, and over 20 miles of navigable river to explore and enjoy. As Kentucky's oldest tourist attraction, Mammoth Cave National Park is the perfect start to this year's Best in Kentucky Awards. As you make plans to travel across the state, check out the events listings in Kentucky Living Magazine and KentuckyLiving.com. Enjoy our national parks, adventure tourism, culinary and music scenes, the world's best horses and bourbon, and so much more. Let's get to more Best in Kentucky winners. Heather, back to you.
Thanks so much, Mike. Well, Kentucky Living is the flagship publication of Kentucky's electric cooperatives, who relay important information to their consumer members while supporting local communities and the Commonwealth. Heading up the communications effort at the statewide association which publishes Kentucky Living is my great friend Joe Arnold. Hey, Joe.
Hey, Heather. Thank you for hosting these awards and for your support of our local communities. I am so proud to be part of this electric cooperative family. You know, Kentucky co-ops are guided by co-op principles and are led by and belong to the people they serve. There are no out-of-town shareholders profiting off a co-op operation. Co-ops, indeed, are not-for-profit, and because they are owned by the people they serve, co-ops look out for the interests of their local consumer members. That means safe, reliable, and affordable electricity and a vested interest in improving the quality of life in the communities that co-ops serve. So Kentucky Living is dedicated to this mission, and we are proud to provide accurate, transparent, and reliable information to our readers because we are made in Kentucky. Speaking of which, we asked Kentucky Living readers to vote for their Made in Kentucky favorites. So here are the winners. In third place, AL81 Winchester. Second place, Elijah Craig Bourbon, Bardstown. And first place, the Sweet Shop and Dessert Cafe, Hodgenville. Oh, fudge! 20 flavors of homemade gourmet fudge on the square in downtown Hodgenville and at festivals all over the state. It's not just fudge, birthday cake, classic chocolate, apple pie, tiger butter, creamsicle, cookies and cream, sea salt, chocolate praline. Again, a Made in Kentucky classic. And speaking of Made in Kentucky, did you know that CNN contributor Scott Jennings is a native of Dawson Springs, Kentucky? He's a former special assistant to President George W. Bush, a founder of Runswitch Public Relations, Kentucky's largest PR firm, and he's written for Kentucky Living and is a friend to Kentucky's electric co-ops. Hey, Scott.
Hi, Joe. I'm so pleased to be a part of Kentucky Living's Best in Kentucky. It's a wonderful way to celebrate our great Commonwealth. And that's what the roughly 200 museums in Kentucky do every day, provide unique places for us to visit and learn about and experience Kentucky. My family loves exploring, and we check out Kentucky Living for ideas every month. Kentucky Living readers have chosen these as their top three museums. In third place, it's Audubon Museum and Nature Center at the John James Audubon State Park. Second place is the Speed Art Museum in Louisville. Been there, very nice. And in first place, the Lincoln Museum in Hodgenville. Located in the downtown Hodgenville National Historic District, the Lincoln Museum welcomes you to wander through the pivotal points in the life of the 16th President of the United States. A series of life-size dioramas, period artifacts, and a superb collection of wax figures brings to life the major events in Abraham Lincoln's life. It's a close-up experience with one of the world's greatest leaders. When you visit, be sure to tell them you read about it in Kentucky Living. Finally, thanks to the publisher of Kentucky Living, the Kentucky Electric Cooperatives. Runswitch Public Relations, where I'm a partner, is a proud partner of Kentucky co-ops because of their outstanding service to their consumer members and commitment to community. Thanks to all the electric co-ops across Kentucky for all that you do.
Proven favorites enter Kentucky Living's Best in Kentucky Hall of Fame by winning first place for three consecutive years. With their first place wins last year, congratulations to these new inductees into the Best in Kentucky Hall of Fame. In the category of Sweet Spot, the Sweet Shop and Dessert Cafe. And in the Distillery category, Maker's Mark Distillery. they joined these prior Hall of Fame inductees in destination categories. Watch for more of the Hall of Fame throughout the Best in Kentucky Awards.
There is so much to see and do in our great Commonwealth. If you can spare a few days, what do Kentucky Living readers say are the best places to spend a long weekend getaway? Well, let's find out from WKYT's Amber Philpott and Sam Dick.
Thanks, Heather, and thanks to Kentucky Living and Kentucky Electric Cooperatives for celebrating the best Kentucky has to offer. You know, I grew up with the Rural Electric Cooperative in Cynthiana, where a highlight of summer was the co-op annual meeting and getting those bucket of light bulbs. We certainly appreciate the hard work of linemen and everyone at the co-ops who keep our lights on.
We sure do, Amber. My family's electric co-op ties also run very deep. My father, David Dick, literally wrote the book on the story of rural electricity in Kentucky. And after he retired from CBS News, his column, The View from Plum Lick, ran monthly in Kentucky Living for 21 years.
Does that mean you have some big shoes to fill in retirement?
Pretty big shoes to fill right there,
we
Amber.
We will see.
But, you know, I think it's a great time to check out the best in Kentucky winners for a long weekend getaway.
Yes, third place, Farmer and Frenchman Winery, Henderson. Second place, Red River Gorge Geological Area, Stanton.
And the winner, Cumberland Falls at Cumberland Falls State Resort Park, Corbin. There's so much to enjoy at Cumberland Falls, the natural beauty, of course, and wonder of a park nestled in the middle of the Daniel Boone National Forest.
Yeah, from the waterfall and the Moonbow phenomenon to hiking the Eagle Falls Trail and other paths crisscrossing forested landscapes. It's beautiful.
It is. And indoors, there are the delicious down-home meals made with Kentucky Proud ingredients at the Riverview Restaurant.
It certainly sounds like a winning combination.
Congratulations to all the best in Kentucky winners. Heather, back to you.
Well, if you love Kentucky history, the world meets Kentucky on Museum Row in downtown Louisville. For our next awards, let's go to the official starting point of the Kentucky Bourbon Trail. Rachel Platt and Andy Trinan join us from the Fraser Kentucky History Museum. Hey, guys.
Thanks, Heather. The Kentucky Bourbon Trail Welcome Center here at the Fraser History Museum is open to visitors free of charge and helps plan trips to bourbon distilleries throughout the state and Louisville hotspots.
Hey, keep an eye out for the October issue of Kentucky Living for a look at some of the newest distilleries and experiences that are opening all across the Commonwealth.
All right, here are the best in Kentucky winners in the distillery category. Third place, Jim Beam American Stillhouse in Claremont. Second place, Evan Williams Bourbon Experience, Louisville.
And the winner, Maker's Mark Distillery in Loretto, Kentucky. This is where the magic happens, in a distillery that operates the same way that it did nearly 70 years ago, from using the old letter press and hand rotating each barrel to hand dipping every single bottle.
And you can do this too. Dip a bottle in the Maker's Mark red wax, known the world over. Book a tour to learn about the bourbon, history, and traditions that concludes with a guided tasting.
Rachel, you know, we are proud to be the official starting point of the Kentucky Bourbon Trail, but also a great place to begin any Kentucky tourism journey.
Kentucky, of course, is home to some of the coolest people, places, and things on earth, and we invite you here as we spotlight both the hidden histories and famous figures of the Commonwealth.
A horseshoe worn by Secretariat. A pair of overalls that George Clooney wore in the movie Oh Brother, Where Art Thou? Magician Lance Burton's straitjacket.
That is some cool Kentucky history. And here's how Kentucky Living readers voted in the category of historic site.
In third place, Shaker Village of Pleasant Hill, Harrodsburg. In second place, my old Kentucky home state park, Bardstown.
And the winner, Abraham Lincoln Birthplace National Historical Park, Hodgenville. Make a pilgrimage to learn about the legacy of America's 16th president, the place where he walked, worked, played, and wandered during his earliest years.
Although the symbolic birth cabin is not the original cabin used by the Lincoln family, it dates from the 1840s and comes from the local area situated on the land where Lincoln lived for the first 7 years of his life. Hey, congratulations to all the best in Kentucky winners. We look forward to seeing you here at the Fraser Kentucky History Museum.
And while you're here, don't miss this piece of Kentucky history, Miss America 2000, her dress and tiara. Hey, Heather, your history.
That is so amazing, and I love that my dress is like the first thing you see when you walk into the museum. What an honor and certainly a privilege, a moment that changed my life forever. Well, the 2021 Best in Kentucky Awards are made possible by the sponsorship of Glasgow Barron County Tourism, where they say, from caves and canoes to culinary delights, all the best adventures start with a little curiosity. Let's go to the executive director of Glasgow Barron County Tourism, McLean Lessenberry.
Hi, welcome to downtown Glasgow in Barron County, Kentucky. I'm the executive director of tourism here, McLean Lessenberry, and we are this year's sponsor of the 2021 Best in Kentucky contest, and we are thrilled about it. From easy small town living to a plethora of eateries, historic attractions, outdoor fun, and unique locally owned shops and boutiques, we've got something for everyone. Nestled right in the heart of cave country, we're a mecca for outdoor adventure. So whether you're a water enthusiast, a thrill seeker, a nature lover, or all three, we've got something for you. Whoever said you can't tour a cave, hike a national park, zip line, water ski, relax on a beach, and cook s'mores over a fire while listening to live music, all in one day, has never been to Barron County. Congratulations to all of this year's nominees. We are thrilled to be your sponsor, and we can't wait to host you here in Barron County.
Thanks so much, McLean, and thanks to Glasgow Barron County Tourism for sponsoring the 2021 Best in Kentucky Awards. Laura Rogers knows a thing or two about South Central Kentucky. Laura is the anchor of AM Kentucky and producer anchor of Midday Live at WBKO-TV in Bowling Green. Hey, Laura.
Hi, Heather. What an exciting day and a great way to celebrate the Best in Kentucky. I am pleased to announce the 2020 Best in Kentucky winners in the category of Place for Adventure. Third place, Cumberland Falls at Cumberland Falls State Resort Park in Corbin. Second place, Red River Gorge Geological Area in Stanton. And the winner, Mammoth Cave National Park. Talk about adventure, hiking, biking, horseback riding, fishing, camping, canoeing, and kayaking, all at Mammoth Cave National Park. It is a World Heritage Site and International Biosphere Reserve. Check out the September Best in Kentucky issue of Kentucky Living for a great article about Mammoth Cave by Graham Shelby. Mammoth Cave National Park boasts 53,000 acres of natural preserve and the longest cave system in the world, with over 4,000 miles of passages and 400 miles of mapped passageways. Congratulations to all the winners. Thanks to Kentucky Living for supporting travel and tourism in Kentucky.
Thanks so much, Laura. Well, time to check back with Kentucky Living Around the Table columnist Heather Bilyeu. Heather, how's it going?
Hi, Heather. Okay, the next part of the charcuterie board is the meats. And a big tip I like to share is usually by the deli section, you can find cured meats in a package together so you don't have to buy all separates. They'll have prosciuttos and salamis and all kinds of stuff. So just buy a package of that and it's all done for you. And I like to arrange it in a really fun way on the board. So I do some folds, some rolls, and even a really fun salami rose, which sounds weird, but I'll show you the tips and tricks. It's really fun. So to do a fold, I like to just fold it in half and then in fourth, and it just makes this really pretty triangle that you can arrange around the cheese, just like so. And the key with this is you're just gonna fill in holes. So there's no rhyme or reason to where anything goes, just stick it on the board and it all comes together at the very end. So we have the folds, and then another thing I like to do is just little rolls, which is just really easy. You roll it into a roll and just like so, and then you can stack it up next to each cheese. And then with the prosciutto, since it's a really thin meat, I'll just take it and do a little pile just all over the board. And that way people can pick it up. And you can't really fold or roll a prosciutto. So it just makes it a really pretty little different textures and shapes and sizes on the board. And just kind of layer it just like so. And then with the salami rose, you're gonna use a champagne flute or any thin glass that you have, it doesn't matter. And you're gonna take a big piece of salami or any kind of cured meat and you're gonna stick it right inside and fold it over the edge. So you're gonna just fold and push over, and you're gonna overlap until you've used all of the slices. just like so, and it's gonna make this really pretty rose that just adds a fun little decorative element that looks like you're super fancy, but it was really easy, which I love. So just one piece over the other, and it gets a little tight in the middle, but just keep on pushing it down, rotating it, overlapping it, folding it over, and then you take it, turn it upside down, and it's this cute little salami rose. So now we have the cheeses done, the meats done, and I'm gonna show you a couple more tips and then the charcuterie board will be finished. In addition to the more than 1,000 homegrown recipes available for free on KentuckyLiving.com, each month I'm so excited to invite Kentucky Living readers into my kitchen each month to share recipes and cooking and entertaining tips. In our Kentucky Eats column, we introduce you to the favorite dining spots of our readers across the Commonwealth. In that spirit, here are the winners for Down Home Restaurant. Third place, Hometown Roots, Henderson. Second place, Kayla's Phillips Station, Hodgenville. And in first place, the Lighthouse Restaurant, Sulphur Well. Roll up your sleeves and tuck into an all-you-can-eat family-style meal in a restaurant with a down-home feel. Located on a country road about 15 minutes from Edmonton, the Lighthouse Restaurant is a stroll across the street from Metcalfe County Historic Sulphur Well Park. It's not Grandma's kitchen, but it sure does feel like it, with heaping helpings from made-from-scratch, family-style meals like fried chicken, catfish, pinto beans, and cornbread, and homemade pies. Congratulations to the Lighthouse Restaurant. And now we go to another homegrown favorite. You read his back page column every month in Kentucky Living. We're so fortunate that the legendary Byron Crawford is a member of the Kentucky Living family. Hi, Byron.
Thanks, Heather. That down-home restaurant category has me thinking about how every town and every family has its own unique flair. You know, the local flavor of our hometowns really comes to life when they host events and festivals. Third place, W.C. Handy Blues and Barbecue Festival, Henderson. Second place, Marion County Country Ham Days, Lebanon. And first place goes to Lincoln Day Celebration, Hodgenville. Pioneer games, rail splitting, Lincoln lookalikes, live music, a classic car show, and more take place at this two-day event each October that's been going on for half a century. Held in the hometown birthplace of Abraham Lincoln, the festival also includes one of the oldest continuously held art shows in the state. We can thank Abraham Lincoln for the quintessential American festival, Thanksgiving Day. Despite the Civil War in 1863, Lincoln saw fit to give thanks for, quote, the blessings of fruitful fields and healthful skies. Not a bad thought, despite any of today's challenges. We thank you for being part of the Kentucky Living and Kentucky Electric Cooperatives family. Heather, back to you.
Thanks, Byron. Well, we're not quite ready for Thanksgiving yet. It's state fair time. So the big question is, what's for lunch? Maybe a Kentucky Pork Producers pork chop sandwich or a Kentucky Cattlemen's Association ribeye sandwich. Maybe even a burger. Here's Kentucky Living Managing Editor Shannon Brock for our next Best in Kentucky winners.
Thanks, Heather. And thanks for returning to again host our show this year. You're a great Kentucky original. Each month in Kentucky Living, we celebrate uniquely Kentucky, unusual, classic, or distinctive people, places, and other original stuff about our great state. Though restaurants in Denver and Pasadena claim to be the birthplace of the cheeseburger, Kentuckians know it was at Kalen's in Louisville. Where can we find Kentucky's best hamburger? Here's how Kentucky Living readers voted. Third place, Kayla's Phillips Station, Hodgenville. Second place, Metzger's Tavern, Henderson. First place, Leahy's Red Castle, Hodgenville. Fresh ground beef smashed to perfection and seasoned just right with onion, then cooked on a circa 1950s Vulcan Heart Grill. Diners have been taking a seat at the Hodgenville lunch counter and enjoying these delicious burgers for more than 80 years. The family business has been around since 1934, with the third and fourth generations carrying on the tradition. Congratulations, Leahy's. Save us a seat at the counter.
Kentucky Living's Best in Kentucky Hall of Fame in Eats and Drinks categories. Kentucky Living's Best in Kentucky Hall of Fame in Entertainment categories. Kentucky Living's Best in Kentucky Hall of Fame in Outdoors categories. Kentucky Living's Best in Kentucky Hall of Fame in Shopping categories.
For over 25 years, Dawn G has graced the airwaves at Wave 3 TV in Louisville, and she is equally known for her commitment to her community and her willingness to step in and help out when a need arises. A past Best in Kentucky recipient, let's go to Wave 3 Studios and say hi to Dawn G. Hey, Dawn.
Hey, Heather, and hello to all of Kentucky watching Kentucky Living's Best in Kentucky Awards. As the mother of three and a grandma, I know what it's like looking for kid-friendly things to do. Thankfully, we are blessed with so many opportunities in Kentucky. And here's what Kentucky Living readers voted as the best kid-friendly attractions in the Commonwealth. Third place, Hinton's Orchard and Farm Market, Hodgenville. Second place, Kentucky Down Under Adventure Zoo, Horse Cave. First place, the Louisville Zoo. Louisville, the State Zoo of Kentucky, currently exhibits more than 1,100 animals on 130 acres of natural settings. One of the region's most popular family attractions, the Louisville Zoo also features concessions and catering, multiple playgrounds, several gift shops, rides and attractions, including the Splash Park, Conservation Carousel, trams, adventure ropes courses, camel rides, and the Boma African Petting Zoo. Plus, the zoo produces education programs recognized nationwide for excellence and over 50 special event days every year. Congratulations to all Best in Kentucky winners. And thank you for letting me be part of it. Back to you, Heather.
Thanks so much, Dawn. And now to another Kentucky television and radio legend, my favorite, Terry Miners. He's been on the airwaves since the mid-70s in Lexington and primarily on WHAS radio in Louisville since 1985. Terry, for as humorous and crazy as you are on radio and TV, what's clear throughout your career is that you truly care about Kentucky and our communities. Welcome to the Best in Kentucky Awards.
Oh, Heather, thanks so much for the introduction. Appreciate that. It's really great to be here and be part of this celebration of the best in Kentucky, thanks to Kentucky's electric cooperatives for their important role and support throughout the Commonwealth. Are you ready? I've got a great category here. The winners in the category of Farmers Market, as voted by readers of Kentucky Living. Number three is Henderson Farmers Market in Henderson, Kentucky. Second place, Lexington Farmers Market, of course, in Lexington, Kentucky. And, ba-da-da, first place goes to Hardin County Farmers Market in Elizabethtown. Located on Peterson Drive in Elizabethtown, more than 20 vendors offer local farm fresh goodness, including fruits, vegetables, eggs, meats, baked goods, jams, and jellies. All this at the Hardin County Farmers Market. You can also find flowers and handmade lotion bars and soaps. This market is grower only, meaning the produce is all local. Just like you, Heather, all local. Back to you.
That's right, Miners. I am all Kentucky proud and Kentucky girl and loving it. Well, this is the 12th year for Kentucky Living's Best in Kentucky Awards and the fifth year of this award show. Kentucky Living is the flagship publication of Kentucky Electric Cooperatives, and we're joined now by the president of that statewide electric co-op association, Chris Perry.
Thanks, Heather. Kentucky Electric Cooperatives is proud to publish Kentucky Living, the most widely circulated publication in the entire state, with a readership each month of more than 1 million people. Our mission, ever since the first edition of Kentucky Electric Cooperative News in 1948, is to create a community of people who take pride in thinking of themselves as Kentuckians and as knowledgeable electric co-op members in order to improve the quality of their life. For 37 years, we called the magazine Rural Kentuckian. And for the last 32 years, the Kentucky Living name has been welcome in homes across the Commonwealth as we feature the character and culture of Kentucky, its people, places, history, lifestyle, and unique characteristics. That's what co-ops are all about, and it's what we celebrate today with Best in Kentucky. I'm excited to announce the 2021 Best in Kentucky winners in the category of golf course. I am blessed to have played at some of the best golf courses in the world, from Pebble Beach to the old course at St. Andrews. And everywhere I go, I talk about the great golfing that we have in Kentucky. In third place, the Bridges Golf Course of Henderson. Second place, LaRue County Golf Course in Hodgenville. And in first place, Barron River Lake State Park Golf Course in Lucas. With manicured playing conditions and beautiful scenery that wraps around the lake and the park, plus a challenging golf course that is both fun and rewarding, this is a course you simply cannot play on. Our mission as cooperatives is to improve the quality of life in the communities we serve. That's why we're proud to partner with the Office of the Governor on Beautify the Bluegrass, an initiative that recognizes beautification efforts in hometowns across Kentucky. And now, to announce the finalists for the 2021 Beautify the Bluegrass winners, here is the 61st Governor of Kentucky, Andy Beshear.
Thank you, Chris. And thanks to Kentucky Living for supporting homegrown beautification efforts across the Commonwealth. Again this year, Kentuckians have inspired us with their projects. And a special shout out to the local electric cooperatives who have led the way. Co-op members, employees, and board members have teamed up to improve their communities, such as Owen Electric weeding and planting new flower beds at a state park. Jackson Purchase Energy picking up trash along busy highways. Gibson Electric Membership Corporation refurbishing the picnic tables at a local park. And Licking Valley RECC installing signage for a county park. When we say Team Kentucky, this is what we're talking about. Kentuckians who care about their communities and take action to help. Thank you to every Kentuckian and co-op who completed Beautify the Bluegrass projects this year. While we can't mention all the incredible entries, here are the finalists for the Governor's Award. McDougal Lake Trail Cleanup and Beautification. Organized by the Knob Creek Conservancy, dozens of volunteers eliminated four farm dumps and years of garbage which had floated onto the shore and alongside the trail at McDougal Lake. Ohio County Amphitheater Stage Reconstruction. Volunteers from Big Rivers Electric Corporation rebuilt a deteriorating wooden stage at the County Park Amphitheater, replacing the old wood and lattice from the stage area and painting the new stage and light tower. Lake Liberty Transformation. More than 100 volunteers, including Casey County High School football players and the 4-H Team Council, working for over 4 months, transformed Lake Liberty, cleared brush, performed both land and water cleanups, and installed new signage and benches. The Monarch Mural. Next to the old jail in Franklin, about 15 volunteers from the Franklin Simpson Garden Club, with the help from the city, created a walkway that protects the Monarch Butterfly Waystation Garden from cars. The volunteers painted a series of murals that show the life cycle of the Monarch. Beattyville City Park Restoration. Historic flooding in March devastated Beattyville City Park. Working alongside several city employees, more than 45 Jackson Energy employees volunteered 630 man hours over a 2-day span, reconstructing the safety fall zone around each piece of playground equipment, shoveling tons of sand and mulch, repairing fencing, plus pressure washing, landscaping, and painting. Leslie County Community Canoe Cleanup. More than 100 community members from students to seniors, worked to remove over 60 cubic yards of garbage and nearly 300 tires from the Middle Fork River and area waterways. Organizers then distributed 66 road quality anti-littering signs throughout the county. The public vote to decide the recipient of the Beautify the Bluegrass Governor's Award is September 6th through 17th on KentuckyLiving.com. We'll announce the winner on September 27th. Finally, as Kentucky Living and Kentucky's electric cooperatives recognize the best in Kentucky and celebrate Kentucky tourism, this is a perfect time to support Kentucky tourism with the Vax and Visit campaign. Eligible Kentuckians who have received their shot of hope can register for a chance to win a Safecation at any of Kentucky's 45 state parks. Safecations include golf, lodging, and campground gift certificates. Kentuckians must be 18 years or older to enter and have received at least their first dose of a safe and effective vaccine. To learn more, visit tah.ky.gov. Now, back to the Best in Kentucky Awards and Heather French Henry.
Thanks so much, Governor. Now to an Owensboro native whose broadcast journalism career has taken her from the University of Kentucky to New York, Chicago, Washington, D.C., and Charleston, South Carolina before coming back to Kentucky, first at WHAS-TV and for the last few years as the host of KET's News Quiz, Kelsey Starks. What do you have cooked up for us today?
Well, hey, Heather, and hello, Kentucky Living. So viewers of KET's News Quiz know that I love keeping everyone up to date on the current events and news of the week with a quiz that helps students stay engaged and informed. So in that vein, here is your News Quiz question. The name Lollipop was trademarked in 1931, but do you know the origin of its name? I'll have that answer for you in just a moment. But first, here are your Best in Kentucky winners in the category of Sweet Spot. In third place is Tipton's Tradition Incorporated in Ashland. In second place, Second Street Treats in Henderson. And first place, Best in Kentucky, is the Sweet Shop and Dessert Cafe in Hodgenville. You can smell the sweet, sugary aroma of fudge and baked goods being prepared even before entering the building in historic downtown Hodgenville. Caramel and gourmet apples, chocolate-dipped strawberries, cupcakes, cookies, and turtle candy, plus 2 dozen flavors of bluebell and velvet ice cream and other goodies to satisfy the sweet tooth. Well, do you remember our news quiz question? Do you have an answer for it? The name Lollipop came from a racehorse that the inventor had seen at a county fair. So now you know. Well, congratulations to all of our Best in Kentucky winners. Back to you, Heather.
Thanks, Kelsey. Well, you are watching Kentucky Living's 2021 Best in Kentucky Award, sponsored by Glasgow Barron County Tourism and supported by many friends and partners throughout Kentucky. Well, before returning to her home state of Kentucky, Claudia Coffey's TV career spanned 8 states, plus CBS News and Fox News in Washington, D.C., entertainment and travel reporting, and even roles in feature films. Her Great Day Live co-host, Eric King, is a Bardstown native who has earned multiple awards in broadcast markets from Montana to Mississippi, Tennessee to Texas, and, of course, right here in Kentucky. Let's go to the Great Day Live studios at WHAS-TV in Louisville. Hey, guys.
Thank you so much, Heather. We enjoy sharing great stories with great people on Great Day Live, and we are thrilled to be a part of Best in Kentucky this year.
Yeah, so after hearing the winners for Sweet Spot, Hamburger, and Down Home Restaurant, I'm starting to build up an appetite. So how about we talk pizza?
Yes, let's do.
Yeah, so let's see who Kentucky Living readers voted for Best in Kentucky Pizza.
In third place, Rock House on the River in Henderson. In second place, Pizza Zone in Buffalo.
And the Best in Kentucky winner, Hometown Pizza.
All right. Nearly 40 years ago, founders Mike and Mary Jane Foster had a vision to serve a variety of delicious pizza creations in a unique and relaxing atmosphere.
Starting in LaGrange and now with 18 locations throughout the central part of the state, Hometown Pizza is a family-oriented restaurant with all kinds of pizza, appetizers, salads, sandwiches, wraps, pasta, entrees, and a pizza dessert made with cream cheese, seasoned fruit, and streusel.
The restaurant freshly shreds its mozzarella daily and sources the best locally grown produce.
Thank you again to Kentucky Living and the Electric Cooperatives of Kentucky for celebrating the energy of Kentucky.
What a great day and a way to recognize the people and places who make Kentucky a great place to live. Heather, back to you.
Thanks so much, guys. Well, we're excited to welcome back Kentucky's Agriculture Commissioner to Best in Kentucky. Under his leadership, the Department of Agriculture has started initiatives to combat hunger and connect Kentucky farmers to new markets. Let's go to Commissioner Ryan Quarles. Hey, Ryan.
Thanks, Heather. Great to see you. Today, many Kentuckians have no direct connection to the farm life, even in rural areas. Agritourism gives them an opportunity to better understand the skill and hard work that goes into producing the food and fiber that we all enjoy every day. And guess what? It's fun as well. Here are the 2020 Best in Kentucky winners in the category of Farm Tourist Attraction. In third place, Kate's Farm from Henderson. In second place, Denison's Roadside Market out of Horse Cave. And the winner, Hinton's Orchard and Farm Market in Hodgenville. It's a great place. Be sure to visit all three of these. No matter the season, there's always a reason to visit Hinton's Orchard and its farmland play area. In the spring, flowers, herbs, and vegetables. In the summer, sweet corn, tomatoes, peppers, blackberries, watermelons, and juicy tree-ripened peaches. And in the fall, pumpkins, mums, apples, and of course, the farmland play area with its hayrise, barrel train, and corn maze. And in the winter, a great selection of custom gift and fruit baskets, live wreaths, and pre-cut Christmas trees ready to take home and trim. Thanks to Kentucky Living and Kentucky's electric cooperatives for being such strong supporters and partners for Kentucky agriculture. In fact, Kentucky Living is an official Kentucky Proud supporter. And the Kentucky Proud program promotes locally grown food, farmers markets, roadside stands, agritourism sites, and many other products and destinations with roots in Kentucky soil. Kentucky Proud stands for Kentucky's Farm Family Businesses. We welcome the Kentucky Departments of Agriculture's Creative Marketing Manager, Tyler Madison, and the Executive Director of Marketing, Melanie McPartland.
Thanks, Commissioner. Kentucky has more than 80 craft breweries and microbreweries that generate more than 800 jobs with an economic impact of $657 million a year.
These breweries often make use of Kentucky Proud products to give their creations a homegrown flair. Here are the best in Kentucky winners in the category of craft beer. Third place, Scout and Scholar Brewing Company in Bardstown. Second place, Henderson Brewing Company in Henderson. And the winner is Country Boy Brewing in Georgetown and in Lexington.
Country Boy Brewing's claim to fame are minimally processed beers, from light lagers to bold and flavorful stouts made with the best ingredients available.
Country Boy Brewing opened in Lexington with their first brewery and taproom in 2012. And since then, they've expanded in Georgetown, where it operates its 22,500 square foot production brewery, taproom, and headquarters.
Buying local products strengthens our local economy by keeping dollars close to home and building a sense of community during the process.
You can serve Kentucky Proud foods or purchase Kentucky Proud products with the confidence that they came from your friends and neighbors just down the road, not from thousands of miles away.
Congratulations to all the Best in Kentucky winners. Heather, back to you.
You are watching Kentucky Living's 2021 Best in Kentucky Awards, sponsored by Glasgow Barron County Tourism. And for this celebration of Kentucky favorites, let's go to one of the Commonwealth's favorite sons. In his more than 2,500 performances, there is no mistaking that singer-songwriter J.D. Shelburne is straight from Kentucky. Hey, J.D.
Thank you, Heather. It's good to be back at a concert. I am performing tonight at Lawrenceburg on the Green in Lawrenceburg, Kentucky for Food Truck Fridays. What a year it has been. 2021 has been amped up with tour dates. We were slammed and we were so grateful to be back on the road playing music and playing and promoting my new record. Speaking of live music, here are the Best in Kentucky Awards in the category of Place for Live Music. Third place, Bush's Saloon and Dance Hall, Glasgow, Kentucky. Second place, Paramount Arts Center, Ashland, Kentucky. And first place, Joel Ray's Lincoln Jamboree in Hodgenville, Kentucky. This country music show has gained a reputation for extraordinary talent at a reasonable price and a family atmosphere that includes a restaurant, campground, and gift shop with jams, jellies, souvenirs, and Kentucky-made items. Founded in 1954 by the legendary Joel Ray Sprouse, the Jamboree now bears his name. That's a perfect tribute. That'll do it from here in Lawrenceburg, Kentucky. Back to you, Heather.
Hey, JD. Well, before you go, we want to say congratulations on all of your recent success. I was so excited to join you at the release of your new album, Straight from Kentucky, at the concert in Taylorsville. It was awesome. We thought you would like to hear the best in Kentucky winners in the musician category. Well, third place, Blackstone Cherry in Edmonton. Second place, Tyler Childers of Lawrence County. And drum roll, please, first place Taylorsville native J.D. Shelburne.
Woo!
Well, congratulations, J.D.
That's awesome. Oh, okay.
Whoa,
I gotta
wait a minute,
first.
J.D., where'd you go?
Oh.
Congratulations.
Thank you so much.
Yeah, now you have to.
Wow. Thank you, Heather. Thank you, Monica. Thank you, all the team at Kentucky Living. My fans for voting. Number one Kentucky musician and band in the state of Kentucky 2021. Wow, I am speechless. Thank you to anyone and everyone that's ever been to a show, that's been on my Facebook, my social media, that's voted for me on CMT, this award. Oh, wow, I can't believe this. I was on the cover of the Tourism Guide. Now I am Kentucky's best musician band of 2021. I think I'll go have a steak. God bless. Thank y'all so much.
What a great Kentuckian.
Awesome.
Well, we'll see if JD can give us one more song before the end of the show. Well, from great performances to the great outdoors, Ken McBroom is the newest columnist in Kentucky Living. He's an angler and hunter who enjoys sharing the many outdoor opportunities that Kentucky has to offer. And he's here with our next awards. Hi, Ken.
Hi, Heather. Thank you. Kentucky has more than 110 public fishing areas and more than 80 locations for public hunting. We asked Kentucky Living readers to tell us their favorites, and here are the 2021 winners in the category of favorite hunting and fishing area. Third place, Bering River Lake at Bering River State Resort Park, Lucas. Second place, Green River Lake, Campbellsville. First place, Land Between the Lakes, Golden Pond. As part of America's Great Outdoors since 1963, Land Between the Lakes National Recreational Area manages over 170,000 acres of forest, wetlands, and open lands on a peninsula between Kentucky and Barkley Lakes in western Kentucky and Tennessee. Great settings for camping, picnicking, hiking, fishing, boating, wildlife viewing, and water sports. Plus, Land Between the Lakes offers licensed hunts for deer, turkey, squirrel, and other small game animals throughout the year. Looking for a great place to pitch a tent or park your RV? It's always camping season in Kentucky, and Kentucky Living readers have made some excellent choices in their Best in Kentucky vote in the category of camping spot. Third place, Red River Gorge Geological Area, Stanton. Second place, Yogi Bear's Jellystone Park, Mammoth Cave, Mammoth Cave. First place, Green River Lake at Green River Lake State Park, Campbellsville. Green River Lake State Park is a recreational paradise in south central Kentucky. Relax in one of the 167 improved campsites with electricity plus 60 other tent sites. Green River Lake State Park now offers Wi-Fi internet access through the campground. Go for a swim at the sand beach or play a game of mini golf. Lots of activities for kids, plus 28 miles of multiple use trails for hiking, horses, and biking. Look for more tips and updates each month in Kentucky Living's Great Outdoors.
Thanks so much, Ken. It looks like a great day on the lake. Well, let's move from Great Outdoors to Around the Table and check back in with Kentucky Living cooking columnist Heather Bilyeu.
Hi, Heather. Okay, we're on to our next part of the charcuterie board. We have our meats and cheeses already displayed, and the next part is fruits and spreads. So I always love to include a couple spreads like whole grain mustard or some fig butter, which is my absolute most favorite. And honestly, a lot of times I'll just put them in little bitty shot glasses or little cups around. It doesn't matter. Use what you have like I always do. And the fig butter just gives it a nice little sweet complement to the meats and the cheeses. You can do things like hummus or any kind of spread or jam that you love. I always love to include some olives because I'm a big olive fan. So the next thing we're gonna do is the fruits and the veggies. The things with the fruit is you wanna make sure that it can set out for a long time, since usually charcuterie boards are just being enjoyed for a longer amount of time. I always love to include some grapes, and this is where the magic of the board starts to happen. So we have everything, it's kind of sparse, and you just wanna start filling in the hole. So there's no rhyme or reason, just put it where there's nothing left already. So we're gonna put some grapes around, which are always really easy to eat for people. And then figs are in season right now, which are my absolute favorite. You can use things like strawberries, blueberries, raspberries. And then I always like to include some vegetables as well. So sugar snap peas, or some little bitty mini peppers that you just cut in half. They're really good like dips if someone wants to do low carb or doesn't want to eat crackers. So with these things, you can just start tucking them around the cheeses and the meats and filling in the holes. And this is where the magic starts to happen and everything starts coming together and it starts looking really beautiful. Now here are the Best in Kentucky winners in the barbecue category. Third place, Red State Barbecue, Lexington. Second place, J&B Barbecue and Catering, Henderson. And the winner, Arrowhead Barbecue, Hodgenville. So much love. Award-winning desserts made from scratch sides like macaroni and cheese and sweet potato casserole, a special recipe barbecue sauce, meat smoked fresh daily, and a smoker loaded down and cooking low and slow over fruit wood. Get a slab of full ribs, smoked chicken leg quarters, and anything else on the menu by a drive-thru or delivery. And Heather, coming up, we'll finish up our charcuterie board.
Thanks, Heather. Well, it looks like our Best in Kentucky menu is taking shape. So ready to pair it with some Kentucky wine? Well, let's check back in with Kentucky Living's Byron Crawford.
Thanks, Heather. America's commercial wine industry was born right here in Kentucky more than 200 years ago. Today, winemaking is a robust and growing industry, with about 100,000 cases or 200,000 gallons of wine coming out of Kentucky each year. Third place, Jester's Winery and Cafe, Lebanon. Second place, Farmer and Frenchman Winery, Henderson. And the winner, Purple Toad Winery, Paducah. With inspiration from a trip to California's Napa Valley in 1998, this winery has been in business for 23 years and is among the top 300 largest wineries in the country. Pretty amazing when you consider there are more than 8,700 wineries in the U.S. Over 50 different wines from dry to sweet are made here, including bestseller Black and Bruised. Tours and tastings are offered anytime the winery is open. Congratulations to all the Best in Kentucky winners. Heather, back to you.
Thanks, Byron. Well, every day on LEX 18 in Lexington, Chief Meteorologist Bill Meck brings his unique blend of humor, education, and accuracy. And he's a past Best in Kentucky winner. Let's go to the Storm Tracker Center for our next awards.
Thank you so much, Heather. Really, no matter where you happen to be houseboating around Kentucky, it's all going to be good, and we're always hoping for that great weather forecast. Sunshine, dry, and low humidity. But we can celebrate some of our very special lakes with the Best in Kentucky. Here are your three winners. Third place goes to Barron River State Resort Park in Lucas. Second place is going to Green River Lake in Campbellsville. And your number one best lake in Kentucky for houseboating, see if you can guess what it is. I'll give you a second here, go ahead. We're gonna retire the award probably after this year and name it for Lake Cumberland, your Best in Kentucky houseboating lake in Somerset, Pulaski County, Russell County, Burnside, Monticello, Wayne County, and Clinton County. Now, as we talk about houseboating, it is the houseboating capital of the world. Expect a huge array of houseboat rentals and amenities, an abundance of water activities, miles of pristine shoreline, irresistible tie-up spots where visitors stake their claim year after year, and the chance to create lasting memories and kindle new friendships. Lake Cumberland is truly a wonderful houseboating destination. Congratulations to all our winners. You really all are the best in Kentucky. Here's hoping your forecast is for sunny skies. Heather.
Thanks, Bill. That's a great forecast for any day. Well, now's a great time to like Kentucky Living on Facebook and follow Kentucky Living on Twitter and Instagram. post your congratulations and celebrations using the hashtag #BestInKentucky. The Kentucky Living team is sharing live updates of all the Best in Kentucky winners. Let's check in with Kentucky Living editor Anita Travis Richter.
Thank you, Heather. We love celebrating the energy of Kentucky and the close connection between Kentucky's electric cooperatives and the communities they serve. I encourage you to check out our Worth the Trip articles each month as Kentucky Living spotlights great places to visit and experience Kentucky, such as the wonderful arts and crafts fairs in our local communities. Here are the 2021 Best in Kentucky winners for Arts and Crafts Fair. Third place, St. James Court Art Show, Louisville. Second place, Glendale Crossing Festival, Glendale. First place, Bardstown Arts, Crafts, and Antique Fair, Bardstown. Mark your calendar now for October 9th and 10th in historic downtown Bardstown. More than 20,000 shoppers come from all over to browse and buy the unique craft and woodworking treasures displayed in tinted booths during the Bardstown Arts, Crafts, and Antiques Fair. Be sure to check the events listing on KentuckyLiving.com for updates on fairs, festivals, and other events this fall. And look for the September 2021 Best in Kentucky issue of Kentucky Living. Heather, on behalf of the entire team at Kentucky Living and Kentucky Electric Cooperatives, thank you for helping us shine a light on the best in Kentucky.
Let's check in one more time with Heather Bilyeu.
We are almost finished with this charcuterie board and it is really coming together. The last couple things I like to do are just what I call fillers and add-ins, and you can do whatever you want. So I love to use some nuts, some dried fruits, and the crackers, and I have a special treat I always like to include at the end. So any kind of nut that you like, I have some just pecans here, and like earlier, you're just gonna put them where there are still empty spaces on the board. And it just kind of fills in and comes all together. So we have some pecans that we'll layer in. I have dried apricots that we'll put over here on this side, and you can use any kind of dried fruit that you like as well, any kind of candied nut that you like. It doesn't matter. There are no rules, no recipes, which is really great. We have some honey roasted peanuts. We're just going to sprinkle them in kind of right here since they're loose so they won't fall out in the corners. And then the crackers, and I always like to use water crackers. They're my most favorite. Plus they're just bland and taste good with any flavor. So we'll have these, and I'll just grab a couple. And I like to spread them out and just kind of tuck them in around the edges, like so, and a little bit over here. And they can overlap too, so that's what kind of what makes it pretty. And the last little thing I like to do is just add a little sweet treat. I always like to include a dark chocolate peanut butter cup. They're my husband's favorite, and it's just kind of a non-traditional element that everyone always loves. So you just take a couple and just kind of put them anywhere where there's a spot. And that's it. So if there's any other holes that you have left, just fill it in with fruits, nuts, spreads, little peanut butter cups, it doesn't matter, and it's all coming together like so, and just beautiful. And congratulations to all the Kentucky Living Best in Kentucky winners. Bon appetit.
That looks amazing, and you know what? Welcome to the Kentucky Living family. We hope you've enjoyed the 2021 Best in Kentucky Award Show, sponsored by Glasgow Barron County Tourism. You can watch a replay and read all about today's winners on KentuckyLiving.com. Congratulations to all the finalists, and thanks to Kentucky Electric Cooperatives and Kentucky Living for making it happen. You are the best in Kentucky. Take it away, JD.
This is called Hometown in My Headlights. I hope you like it. Yeah. Been a while since I've been back around here. Sure looks like ain't nothing's changed. Same two lanes, same two red lights, same number on that population sign. Happens every single time I drive down May. This windshield's like a movie screen, playing back those memories. Cheap cold beer at an old boombox, party going down in the parking lot. First time flames and Friday nights, tailgate talks and crossing lines. Happens to me every time I got my hometown in my headlights. My hometown.
Sanchez.